Last week, we went over some fierce battles in Lineage W. Let's get the scoop on this past week's hot battles and issues. First order of business. Did everyone get their unique weapon crafting recipe? The first login check reward in Lineage W was a unique weapon crafting recipe. Can you guess which weapons were crafted the most by each class? Let's find out now. First, we had the crafted unique weapons that were popular among the knights. The third most crafted weapon is the Great Sword of Blood. The second most is a Sarabi Longsword. The most popular is the Death Blade, which is a melee weapon that deals bonus damage to undead and has a weapon damage protection option. Next, we have the most crafted unique weapons for elves. The third most crafted is a Sarabi Longsword. The second most is the Flaming Bow. The most crafted weapon is the Lunar Longbow, which is a ranged weapon with a special trigger effect that can be activated upon attacking. Now, we have the Magicians. Since this class can't equip very many weapons, the choices were mostly divided between two. The second most crafted weapon is the Magic Dagger, and the most popular weapon is the Dark Stygian Staff. As many magician players have gone for the strength stat, a considerable proportion of magicians have crafted the Magic Dagger. Last but not least, let's see what the Monarchs crafted. The third most crafted is the Magic Dagger. The second most is the Sarabi Longsword. The most popular is the Death Blade. The results are somewhat similar to the Knights, as they use melee weapons too. If you haven't decided on which unique weapon to craft, maybe looking at which weapons are popular among other players of your class may help you make a decision and go for it. Now, let's take a look at some of the battle highlights in different servers. First off, let's look at the Ava 7 server. The fight had been neck to neck so far. Will we finally have a winner? Apparently, the Inbum group was the first in the server to acquire the Immune to Harm skill, which is powerful enough to turn the tide. The Inbum group has announced that they will utilize the power of the Immune to Harm skill to dominate the server by hogging all the boss monsters that let you learn powerful skills. We shall see if the Inbum group will actually prevail, with three of their members wielding the power of Immune to Harm skill. Next, we have news from the Joe 6 server. This is the server with an unusual international alliance. However, as we have seen last week, the Taiwanese group is still not pulling their weight, and the Monmon group is losing to the Bulldog group. The Monmon group tried a strategy of concentrating their attacks on key enemy players to defeat them all at once, but the actual battle was different from their simulations. In the end, they were defeated in most of the battles. Last Wednesday, the Taiwanese group, led by the streamer Kim Sun Poon, joined the battle for once, and the Monmon group had some choice words to say to them. The power gap would be insurmountable without the alliance with the Taiwanese players. Will the Monmon group find another way to come out ahead? Or will the Bulldog group continue to reign supreme in the server? Lastly, we have news from the Ava 9 server. Last week, we heard that the Taiwanese group had been prevailing, while the Imunju group refused to stay down and kept on fighting. Imunju's group did win a few battles and seemed confident that the South Korean players would come to dominate the server in the end. However, they might have been overly optimistic. While the Taiwanese team would give up on some of the skirmishes and retreat when their numbers were lacking, when it came to strategically important battles, such as major boss raids, they absolutely pounded on the Korean players and showed the power of their team. Even so, the Imunju group seems to think that the Taiwanese group will fall apart eventually, as they are a bunch of different blood pledges working together for now. Over time, we shall see which group has the more cohesive teamwork.